In this week's Tuesday tutorial, we'll see how to use a hidden feature, Step and Repeat. This function that doesn't actually have the name Step and Repeat, but it's what people refer to it as, is actually Repeat Transformation Again, is a more accurate name perhaps. But what it lets you do is any transformation you've done, you can then repeat it automatically. And it's very useful for a number of different purposes, not the least of which is if you want a series of objects, for example, spread out exactly the same amount and you don't want to have to do the math, that's what this is good for. So here's an example of something I'd like to end up with, is a whole bunch of these boxes evenly spread apart. So here's how I would approach that. Make a new layer, and first of all, I'm just going to make a square selection and then fill it with my background color. I'm going to press Command Delete on the Macintosh or Control Backspace to do that, and then I'm going to deselect it. Now, it's very important that I deselect it, because otherwise all these objects would end up on the same layer, which wouldn't let me adjust the spacing. So even though I might end up with one layer, I'm going to initially do them separately. So I'm going to deselect by pressing Command and Control D. Now, normally when you do free transform, you press Command or Control T for transform. What we're going to do is also throw in the Option key. So that means it's Command Option T on the Macintosh, Control Alt T on Windows. And what that tells free transform is you're transforming a copy, not the original. So now I'm going to hold down my Shift key because I want to move in a straight line, and I'm going to move this box, say, there. I don't know how far that is, but that's the distance I want, and I hit Enter. Now, I'm going to press a keyboard shortcut combination, which is going to allow me to repeat whatever I just did. Command, Option, Shift, so basically all the keys, T, or Control, Alt, Shift, T. And each time I press that, it's going to make another new layer that distance apart. Now, in an ideal world, the spacing might be perfect, and this one's not too bad, but let's pretend for a moment that I realize I didn't want 10 squares, I only really wanted 8, so my spacing is a little off. So I'm going to delete these two layers, and then take the last one, again hold down the Shift key, and say I want it to end up over here. So now obviously the spacing is off. Now the top layer is selected. All I have to do is scroll down a bit, hold down the Shift key, and select the bottom layer. Whenever you have layers selected and you have the Move tool as your active tool, these options align up here, and the ones on the right distribute, which means spread them out. So I'm going to distribute by their centers, and now all my boxes are evenly spread out. And at this point, you could either merge them or make a smart object. I would probably do the latter, only because that way I can still continue to edit them. So I'll just right click and choose Convert to Smart Object. So now it looks like one layer, but still has all those separate layers below. But what's interesting about this is it's not just for things like spacing. This keyboard shortcut combination quite literally means repeat the previous transformation. So whatever you just did, do it again. So this time I brought in a part of a photograph of a clock face, and I'm going to do the same thing, Command Option or Control Alt T. I'm going to move it, but not just move it, I'm also going to rotate it and make it a little smaller. So this time, these are the things that will be repeated when I do that keyboard shortcut. I moved it, I rotated it, and I scaled it. So all those three things will be repeated. So first I have to hit Enter to tell it to finish. Now, again, Command Option Shift T or Control Alt Shift T. And every time I do, you'll see it's making a smaller and a smaller one that's scaled and rotated. So lots of different possibilities for this. And the key things you have to remember is you want to make sure if you have made a selection, deselect it first, because ideally you want the results, at least initially, to each be on a separate layer. Then you can use alignment commands, you can move them independently, whatever you want. So for example, in this case, if I decide I do want to start playing around with each of these layers, I still can. This is just where they initially ended up. This would actually be a good example of using auto select. Would be a whole lot easier, because then I can just click on the appropriate layer and change them. As I mentioned, some people refer to this as step and repeat, which is kind of an okay name, but it misses the fact that it's really repeating the transformation. So it's not just simply repeating it over and over again, it's repeating whatever transformation you've done. As you saw in this example, multiple transformations are possible. So lots of really cool possibilities with this very cool function. As always, please tune in every week for another Tuesday tutorial. I would ask you to please like and subscribe. And as always, I always mention, if you have Photoshop using friends that you think this would be useful, please share it to them as well. And come back next week for another free Photoshop Tuesday tutorial. I'm Dave Cross. Thanks for watching.